Dartmouth.
Another big crowd here tonight at the stadium.
Welcome to the Carlin Lynch Activity Center.
We're ready to go here from the stadium.
That will go. Coach Lassie getting her team fired up. What a game.
Nothing fancy, just end the game.
Not returned, and the point goes to the Indians. Deflected in! Oh, what a save.
The Indians get the point.
What a solid hit.
Goal!
Yes, she does!
They may not catch him. Puts the Indians on the board.
The Indians will win it.
The crowd is going crazy.
Wow! Dartmouth is going to the Final Four, baby!
Wave them with the knees, they know you with their friends, you got it. Let them know that everything, they nailed down, head down, everything, big.
Cinderella about to lose the glass off a foot. And when I find it, it's when I find you. And we can do the things we never got the time to. Better late than never, but never late is better. They tell me time is money, but we'll spend it together. I'm down for whatever, you just lead the way. We go to dinner, y'all don't even look at me to pay. Mature women with more than me were the first to tempt me. And Jason had this girl Tammy with a purple Bentley. How she got it, I ain't never get to ask. Got to see that she was fine like a ticket on the dash. Yeah, but shout out to the homeowners. The girls that got diplomas and enough money to loan us a little something extra, should we ever need it. If it sounds like you, then let me hear you repeat it.
Oh, you're fancy, huh? Oh, you're fancy, huh?
Big man. Good evening, and welcome to tonight's volleyball match between New Bedford Volk and your Dartmouth Indians! If you could not tell, tonight is our senior night, which is a very bittersweet moment as we have eight very special seniors. But before we get to them, we would like to honor Volk's seniors. Number 9, Haley Rivers. Number 10, Lena Ross. And number 11, Kelsey Montero. Head coach for Volk is Eric Acosta, assisted by Tiffany Silva, Brad Morin, Jessica Gonzalez, and Casey Clark. All right, and now for your Dartmouth Indian seniors! Starting off tonight, we have mom and dad, Mr. and Mrs. Velasquez, escorting captain number 13, Gabby Velasquez. Senior captain, number 22, Brooke Davis, escorted by her mother and father, Mr. and Mrs. Davis, and superfan Reed Davis. Escorting their daughter, number 2, senior Adeline Ablett. Aruda, as well as sister Abby, escorting senior number 4, Olivia Aruda. Number Next up tonight, escorting senior number 5, Victoria Cavallo, we have mom and dad, Mr. and Mrs. Cavallo. Next, escorted by her mother and father, Mr. and Mrs. Jenkins, is senior number 10, H.I.J. Haley Jenkins! We have Mr. and Mrs. Strozek escorting their daughter, number 11, Elena Strozek! And last, but certainly not least, escorted by her mother, brother, and sister, we have number 12, Madison Goldesen! We would like to give a big thank you to DCTV for being here tonight, Mr. Jeffrey Martin for creating the slideshow, Ms. Lemieux for scoring on point all the time, and I would like to thank all of you for wearing my wonky superfan shirts that I made in my living room. All right. If you will all rise for the singing of our national anthem by freshman player Catherine Gifford, our flag is on the other side of the divider.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say
begin tonight. I also want to recognize we have some DVB royalty in the house. We have Lauren Pyre somewhere up there and a bunch of alumni families.
Dartmouth Community Media brings you game number 2 of 3 of senior week. Ben Smith on the call for you guys today, and so far we have made it halfway through the work week. The 15-4 Greater New Bedford Volk Tech Bears against the Dartmouth Indians. Ben Smith on the call once again. Hoping you all are enjoying your wonderful evening, as I am so far. Excited for a great matchup between the Greater New Bedford Volk Tech Bears and the Dartmouth Indians once again. Senior night tonight. And I got to say, this has been one of the realest of the teams I have seen, the seniors, and it's bittersweet. And I was up with Haley, talking with Haley Jenkins before the game, and I almost got teary-eyed because it really goes to show that I've been part of this for 2 years now, and this is this team. I watch this team throughout, even through the pain, through the suffering too. But anyways, senior night here at the Lynch, about to begin for Dartmouth. Aruda to serve. We are underway here at the Lynch. Touched up, served up in the air, trying to chase it down off of Goldson, and right away goes the wrong way for Dartmouth as a 1-0 Volk lead to start off this contest. Kelsey Montero to serve. Touched up. Now to Goldson. Digs it down right in front. Montero. To no avail as that ball will sail out. And the H.I.J. Jenkins to serve. Touched up, McCormick. She's been red hot this year. Touched again, off the Volk defender there. That is Haley Rivers, as that will go inbounds on Volk's side. Touched off of her, and another Dartmouth point. 2-1 Dartmouth. Touched up. And double touch there as... not a perfect way to start off for Volk as Brooke Costa, the libero. Touched up McCormick. A little bit of miscommunication as that goes out. McCormick to serve. Touched up from Strozik to Davis. Puts it right down underneath. A great dig there, right there by Volk. Touched up. Goldson. Great dig right underneath from McCormick. Hits the net there as the streak will end. 4-2 Dartmouth. Goldson to serve. Served it. Touched up from Costa. And that goes out of bounds, inbound. It stays in as Volk will get the point there. The serve here for Lena Ross. Touched up. Ablett puts it down. Adeline Ablett on senior night gets the kill to start off. And now Davis to serve for the Indians. Serves it over. Dig right in front from Kupiak as she was unable to keep it up in the air. 6-3. What? Once again. Touched up from Tevz. And a kill from Ablett! Putting it down! Adeline Ablett! Already 2 kills down! How many more to go? Touched up from Tevz. Once again, and McKinnon off of Kupiak. 8-3 Dartmouth. They have been electric to start off this game. And I will look McKinnon. Touched up. Batted away. A point goes to Volk. But great hustle there. So Adeline Ablett, this came in the first pamphlet today as they were honoring the seniors. Adeline Ablett, she has been playing. Another point there for Volk. Adeline Ablett, you know, her favorite volleyball memory is beating Barnstable last year. And that was probably one of my favorite memories as well. And I was on that game. I think it was senior night, and people were doubting Dartmouth, like, big time. Ball will sail out as the Indians get a point there. Velasquez to serve. Serve from Velasquez. Touched up. And again. Nine to six, Dartmouth. But Ablett, she said, after I graduate, I hope to attend a four-year college in New England area, then go to medical school to pursue a career in dermatology. Off of Davis as the Indians stall another point there for the Bears. The serve for Volk, touched up, off of Jenkins, hits the net there, 8-9. Served, touch up, Jenkins tips it up, McCormick bats it up in the air, goes out of bounds and ends the streak for Volk. Touched for McCormick. Laying it down right underneath as a dig attempt fails from Brooke Davis. 9-10. Brooke, another senior. Her favorite memory was beating Barnstable. That day, that moment is not only my favorite volleyball moment, but a core memory of my high school too. There's nothing more beautiful than sharing a moment. So many people. Keeping it alive. We'll continue with that story afterwards. As that one will sail out of bounds. It barely hit the inline. But she said, there's nothing more beautiful than sharing a special moment to so many people with people you love the most. I have never been more proud of my girls, my teammates. And she plans to pursue her academic career and intention of seeking a bachelor's degree in neuroscience to receive a master's to decorate degree down the road. Dr. Davis. Another point there for Volk as they got caught by a double touch. Jenkins! And that's what I'm telling you. Is that the dogs are barking today. Jenkins to serve. Touched up. Ablett puts it down! Adeline Ablett! Three down run right away in the first set for Adeline. Touch from McCormick. Off the foot of Goldson. but was actually going to hit the ground as another point goes to Volk. McCormick to serve again. Touch up from Strozek. Now Davis.
Ooh.
Dangerous situation. Aruda was right in front. But she couldn't get the kill that she wanted there. Way too hard hitting out of bounds there as another point goes to, and the chants finally break out. And an ace from McCormick. They make an adjustment here on Dartmouth's side would be perfect start. So, ball will sail out. Goldson today said she, her favorite memories, the seniors on the team, now freshman. Ablett once again gets a second chance opportunity, the third chance opportunity, touched up once again to Davis. And I don't know about that call there. That's a kill right there. Let's look. That's a kill.
Thank you,
Ben. And once again, another point given to Volk. Dartmouth's got to stand their ground here. McCormick. And that's in. It's the replay here for the Indians as, hit off the defender there. And hits the net. Volk. Dartmouth has never lost a set on DCTV in 28 sets, by the way. At the Carl Lynch Activity Center, by the way. Right in front. Another point for Dartmouth. Now this is the moment where Dartmouth picks up the pace here. Olivia Arruda, another senior on this team, says her favorite memory is winning against Barnstable last year. Oh, sails out of bounds. And she wants to earn a bachelor's degree in exercise science and future study in conditioning field. Touched up. Now McKinnon. Touched up from McCormick. Ball sails inbounds. Barely catches him. And Jenkins. Right down underneath. And that's going to go out of bounds. Another Dartmouth point. Dartmouth still in it. See, this is what I'm talking about. Dartmouth gains their momentum after they get, like, once they, because this is what I saw earlier this year against Brockton. and Davis. Putting it right down. Now McKinnon, break and a kill! Chloe McKinnon! Bang, bang, bang. Oh! A collision there from Strozik and Davis. And Jenkins, a little bit too far out. Did she touch the finger, though? All right, I just want to look at this replay. Could you go slow on this one? All right. I think she got her hair on it. That's it, to say the least. I don't know where they've seen the hands, but pretty good crowd turnout tonight. And as the Indians coming up to start off this game, WEI reporter Andy Hart in the building, as you can see on that camera shot right there. JV, a big win today against Volk. Put him in two sets. Dartmouth trying to do the same thing JV did. This is Dartmouth. If you believe in miracles, this is the miracle you got to believe in right now. Touched up. Jenkins! Oh! Already down there! A kill from Haley Jenkins as it hits the libero, Brooke Costa. And it hits the rafters as Dartmouth has once again regained its momentum. This is what I'm telling you. Dartmouth is never afraid. This is what they do. In almost every single... Underneath. And now we'll go out and Dartmouth will regain its feet here. Jenkins to serve. And that's out. And another timeout from Lassie. This is not a perfect way to start off for Dartmouth. I think they did the same thing to Dennis Yarmouth. Dartmouth's got to score at least four. As we honor the seniors tonight on senior night. Dartmouth wants. Here's a serve from McCormick. And underneath, a dig from Strozik. And a beautiful save from Golden. And Volk has 1 point left. to end the set. Dartmouth's got to get at least four here. A dig right underneath. Another point for Dartmouth. Double touched. Dartmouth trying to hold Folk. Using the easy serve momentum. Going out of bounds once again. 23-24. Maddie's got to do another timeout for Volk this time around, as we will go again with the senior talking again. So Gabby Velasquez, she said her favorite memory is beating Barnstable with laughing as well. Also the team sleepover at Lena's and the Spag junior year at Aaron's. And she plans to major in undergrad to pursue a master's degree to become a nurse practitioner. Chase your dreams, Gib. Most of these volleyball players are looking to go into the medical field after this, too. So is Haley Jenkins. She's got the same thing. Barnstable as well. With Ava getting a kill to end the game. McCormick. Underneath. Davis. And out of bounds. And Dartmouth's still alive, you gotta know that. Off McCormick. And a point there for Volk, as they need one more to close out the set. Touched up. Ablett right in front from Strozek. Ablett again, second chance opportunity. It hits the net. Dartmouth's still alive. Davis to serve. From Costa, McCormick. Over to the near side, Tevz, touched up. Here's Ablett, puts it down! A kill there, and Dartmouth is 1 point away from taking the first set. A timeout for Volk. And let's look at an Insta replay here. See, the amount of times I gotta say, her height advantage and great timing on that ball and able to lay the one down. Dartmouth. Looking to close out the first set as they are in good position right now. The serve for Brooke. Touchdown for McCormick. Tevz, out of bounds, ends the first set. Dartmouth up 1-0. Are you not entertained? 27-25 at the end of one set, down and a couple more to go. Dartmouth up. We'll be right back right after this. Do not go anywhere, folks. And what a crazy back and forth first set it has been. Dartmouth up 1-0 after the first set. Ben Smith on the call for you guys today. And I gotta say, Dartmouth has just been lights out to start off the set. And showing it off on senior night. I told you guys, I've seen this team before play. And they don't do, they struggle when they try to close out a set. But they did the same thing to Dennis Yarmouth. It was back and forth. And Dartmouth won that set. And then they were up 16-1. I don't know if they might do this time around, as they have all senior starters out there for the Indians. To serve for the Bears is Tevz. To start the second set, we are waiting on a little bit of a word from the officials. And Morgan Tevz to serve. Now Davis, right in front. Touched off. Another point for Dartmouth. They have been on a 4-0 run. Attack there from number 10, Elena Ross. batted off the fingertips of Goldson. Oh. Bad timing on the ball there as the Indians will give a point up to Volk. I don't know. That could have been three hits or a double touch there. And that will go once again. Another Dartmouth point for the Indians. Bad serve there for number 9, Haley Rivers, going the wrong way in that direction. Lena Rivers, she's been red hot. Trying to look like Ablett as it goes off the fingertips of Lena. Once again. Talking to my homeboy here, Dennis. You're on television now. off of McCormick and another Dartmouth point. Trying to tell him to put on a shirt, this Dartmouth Superfan shirt I've been dying for. And a serve from Davis. Hits the net again. Another mistake for Volk. Dartmouth, the 5-0 run.
There we go, bro. Ace up, man.
A left-hand jabber from Strozik. Now over to McKinnon. Putting on an attack, another dig there for the Bears, as that is Haley Rivers, another. Is there two number nines on this team? I can't tell. Oh, one. Tebs, I meant. I can't tell by the numbers. Seven, four. A lot of enthusiasm as McKinnon, and again, goes up on the rafters. Touched up. Now Ablett, try to lay down the dagger. Second chance opportunity. Oh, just aimed it too far down. Another mistake there from Strozik, trying to take a dig. We hope you guys are enjoying your evening if you just tuned in from girls soccer. Tuning in, doing two screens at once, girls soccer and girls volleyball. It has been just an electric first set for the Indians as they started off, as they finished the set, not at the usual 25 mark. They were at the 27 mark this time around. hits the rafters. I mean, that should be a point for Dartmouth there. I don't know about that. And they finally call a point on Dartmouth as Ablett on the attack batted off the hands of the Volk defender. That was more than three touches. A great dig from Velasquez. Touched up. Tevz. Near side. Touched up again. And Jenkins. And sailing out of bounds. Letting all the dogs out. The dog pound is here. And another ace. Over here like Ace Ventura. Gabby Velasquez to serve. Laces out. One of the greatest Jim Carrey movies of all time as it hits the net. 8-10.
Come on, Dartmouth!
Dig right underneath, hits the wrist of Jenkins. Another mistake there for Haley. Another serve for Volk. Touched up. Jenkins. Is that? I'm kind of confused. I can't tell if she touched it or whatnot. All right, let's look at a replay of this because I was confused. Yeah, barely. And it, another Dartmouth point once again. McKinnon there. Avery Santos on the kill. Santos to serve. And goes out of bounds. What? I don't know if she got it out of bounds. If it was in. Hits the net. And let's look at the last replay, which I thought, yeah, that's in. Which I was confused. I thought it, Dartmouth. And a point for Dartmouth as it sails out of bounds. I don't think they realized they got the point there. Touched up. Hits the net again. Volk, another point for Dartmouth. And Aruda to serve. Touched up from McCormick. Over to Tevz. Laying it down. and Davis a little too far out. It's Milo. Our cameraman. Now Jenkins. Putting it down, Haley Jenkins! The dog pound is loud. And again, Dartmouth, as it's off. Another ace for H Dog. Haley slipped out as another kill for Greg Davis. This time around. The HIJ chance. Abrupton. Now we gotta get the student section to be chanting HIJ. And another point for Dartmouth, that's it. Brooke Davis gets her fair share. And a timeout taken by the Bears. And it really goes to show that these girls are not giving up. Let's go back to the senior pamphlet once again here. As Victoria Carvalho, her favorite memory was the bus rides from to and from every game. It brings the level of team together. No matter what level you are on, you always felt united. After high school, she plans on going to college and majoring in either nursing or pursue a dual degree as a physician assistant. And Jenkins a little too far out of bounds there. The girls are trying to have their time of their lives on this court right here. As it's all they got on senior night. Touched up. Now Davis. A chase down for the ball as McCormick tried to get it, but it was too late. Another point there for the Indians. High touch and grab for McCormick. A touch, a block there from Ed Davis laying it down. Brooke Davis, just excellent timing on that ball. Excellent position, excellent timing. There's a lot of excellence I could say in this situation right now. Hits the net again, and the point goes to Volk. Volk 15-4 this season. And Dartmouth beat them the first time 3-0. And looking for a sweep in both sets and matchups this time at home. Now here's the serve. Touched over. A block from Ablett. Once again, Another block from Ablett and Strozik. Now Ablett touches it over. And a point for Dartmouth. I think it was a little bit out of bounds. It looked close. I think it was off the defender there on that play. Look at this crowd show out tonight. And we want to welcome our viewers at home who are just tuning in on Dartmouth Community Media as another point goes for Dartmouth, 21-16. A lot of plans for this week as the Indians go to Case after this matchup. And just been red hot electric. Continuing to be that way, going the wrong way. The coach trying to save it. But the player's opportunity is for that, is that decision. Timeout taken for Volk once again. And they both are utilizing their timeouts. Both sides, I see, they've just constantly utilized their timeouts because they don't like the way the how they're doing right now, how they're transitioning. And it might be a useful timeout for Volk here. And Dartmouth has enough 3 points left remaining. And as we go to our next one, Elena Strozik, as she... her favorite memory was preseason team sleepovers, spags before every game, and matching with teams at school, and school bus rides to the games. And she's pursuing a major in oceanography, a minor in marine sustainability. Excuse me. Tongue twister a little. The Crazy Eight, as they call themselves. Just been crazy. But Lassie calls them the Elite Eight. You could call them either way. I mean, at the same time, they're both the same. And I'm saying this in a nice way when I say crazy. Because they're a hilarious team to be a part of. And I wouldn't blame any of these girls, no matter what. There we go, Ty. Velasquez to serve. And hits the net there as Volk gives up another point to the Indians. And the crowd erupts. The here we go Dartmouth chants. They need more of that. Not two. Right in front, hits the net again as it was touched multiple times and it was out of bounds at the same time. 24-18. The Indians trying to close out the set here to make it 2-0. Strozik to serve, touched up. McCormick right in front. Double touched again from the Indians as the referees suck them from the blood. And Dartmouth finished it off. Golson. 2-0 Dartmouth. Let's look at an instant replay here. As Golden, perfect timing, perfect swing. And Dartmouth takes that set. The final there, 25-18. We'll be right back right after these commercial breaks. Do not go anywhere, folks.
The competition, the sacrifice, and team unity are the cornerstones of life for each and every one of us here.
Never in my wildest dreams. And when you're on chemo, you do have wild dreams. Did I ever think I would be inducted into this Hall of Fame?
My Dartmouth High School athletic days are some of my fondest memories.
I wish all of you in one day of your life could feel what this feels like. To do something you love for years and to be honored like this.
A Hall of Fame is something that is a great accolade. It's something that, you know, we've all walked into that front area at Dartmouth High School and seen those pictures on the wall. It's such an honor to be able to have my face on there.
Dartmouth Pride is more of, you know, wearing green, wearing Dartmouth across your chest, being part of a team, being part of a family. And basically just the spirit of it, you know, having the Dartmouth pride to get you through those 4 years.
So much more than just these stats and these wins and these titles. It's this passion, this contagious feeling of Dartmouth athletics and its legacy. It has so much heritage, and it's passed on year after year because of people who are here tonight, because of the coach.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to this telecast of Dartmouth High Community Media. Ben Smith on the call for you guys today. And how can you phrase this game in one word? Back and, I wouldn't say back and forth. Crazy. I'll say crazy. I could tell you that the Indians just have been looking pretty sharp. Along with Volk, they've been looking really sharp as well. And you could have seen it in the first couple of sets. The Indians to serve. Again, McCormick digs it right underneath as it's double touched. Kind of confused on that call there too, but Volk again to serve. Laying it down, there's Jenkins, try to get the kill. Second chance opportunity this time around. She gets a tip over. And a block from Goldson. Laying it down. Let it rain. And a who let the dogs out? Tony did it on that time around. And an ace for the Indians. And a great turn of events as Dartmouth trailing 0-1 to start off. This is a beautiful ace there. Laying it right down the middle. Touched up. Now Davis. A kill from Davis. 4-1 Dartmouth. H.I.J. A little bit too far there. Ends the streak of 4-0 as Jenkins goes out and Velasquez comes in for the Indians. Davis. Swinging and goes off the Volk defender, and another point for the Indians. And goes out of bounds. Great eyes by Davis as she will let that one go. and Goldson to serve. Ooh, a little bit too hard there for Brooke Davis as that one will hit the net. And another Dartmouth point. Volk. Ablett gets the point for Volk. And Davis, right down in front, hits the sticks, however. A bit of a miscommunication as Dartmouth gives up a point to Volk. Touched up. Now Davis. Right in front. Another serve from the Indians. There is Brooke Davis again. McCormick touched up over to Avery Santos. She's unable to get that one. As it goes to the other side, Santos won again. Once again, third chance opportunity unfails as Dartmouth again, another point as that ball will sail right out of the corners. And an ace for the Bears. They are, gutsy decision. And a serve from Davis, touched up from the libero. McCormick right in front. And Velasquez, a beautiful save as it hits the upright of the inline. And another serve for the Indians. See, in playoff volleyball, which is going to happen sometime next week, which is of course going to happen next week, they would have like four referees at this game. One's with the flag, the other one is with another one with the flag on both sides. That ball sails out of bounds, 10-7 Dartmouth. And once again, the Indians will put up another point as Davis will serve for the Indians. Served up, touched up from Tevz. From McCormick back to Tevz. A dig there underneath from Velasquez. McCormick. And barely stays in bounds there as Haley Rivers keeps it in for the Bears. 11-8 Dartmouth. The serve here for Rivers. Touched up. Ablett. And that should be out of bounds. That was a... could have been a kill. Thank you. And McKinnon gives up another point. Oh! I think it's, they messed up the score there. Yep, 11-10. I was like, is it a Dartmouth point or? It's off the noggin of the umpire. Oh man. Oh. Sports Center not top 10. Oh, another point for Volk. Oh, man. Another. It just. It was totally unaware of. Well, that's your daily comedy of the. Another Dartmouth point there. Just the way it hit off his noggin, just. I get it happened like four plays ago. But... And Dartmouth gets another point. Talk about SportsCenter not top 10. And another point for the Indians as it goes the other way this time. And they're not letting any dogs out of this kennel tonight. Velasquez hits the net. McKinnon way too far out. Another point for the Bears. Out of the park. The crowd's telling me what to do today. All right, another point given from Volk as Haley Jenkins hits the net. 15-14. There we go, Mike. There we go, Dad. McKinnon, another point for Dartmouth, ties it up. 10-1 to go for Dartmouth. Strosick to serve. Going back the other way this time around. And over to Golisen, hits the net. As point goes to Dartmouth. Volk. Volk gets the point there. They messed up the scoreboard, but and Volk fans are disappointed because of the score. I don't. How did she double touch it though? I don't know, man.
Come on, Dartmouth!
Dartmouth not trying to not give up on senior night, going for the clean sweep against Folk. The serve. Digged underneath from Goldazen. Goldazen, once again, a kill there for Maddie Goldazen. Hits the net. Another point drawn for Dartmouth. That is Morgan Hayes there. Hits the net again. Oh, the other side this time. I got confused. And Jenkins going the other way this time around. Here's the serve. Touched up. And another point drawn for Dartmouth. Jeff Martin's having a field day with all of this today. Touched up, Ablett. The other side this time. And Davis. Great execution from Davis as it's 20-19 Dartmouth. And the serve. Touched up. And hits out, hits the out of bounce stick. And a timeout for the Indians. And the Volk crowd. Abrupts. All right, let's look at the replay of one of the best plays of the night presented by Fail Army. Boing! I feel bad for the poor guy, but like, it's just a funny, I don't mean to be disrespectful. Here's Jenkins to serve. Serves it over. McCormick right in front of there. Goes down the other side. Touched up. Here's Strozik, brings it up the other way. McCormick giving it over to Lena. Touched up Lena once again, who has been really great. Lena Ross. Ablett putting it down. Adeline Ablett, three more to pull, 4 points to go. Austria, Austria. The hit, oh, hits the net this time around. Not the way she wanted it that time around. But now McCormick to serve for the Bears. Out of bounds. Dartmouth point. Dartmouth, just 1 point, 2 points away, excuse me, from taking this great matchup tonight. Served up out towards the bench. As the point goes for Dartmouth, they are 1 point away from winning it all on senior night. Goldson, it's the final regular season game. We'll probably see the seniors here tonight. Touched up, batted away, keeping it alive. Velasquez underneath it, shoots it the other way. And goes out of bounds. Oh, inbounds. And 24-21. As Dartmouth still trying to close out the set, this time around late, Lena Ross. Touched up, Davis. Try to get the game right there, and that is game. The Dartmouth Indians win on senior night tonight. And your final look around, I'm in the Dartmouth Superfan shirt, just upgraded. And the final score of the game, 25-21 at the end of the third set, 3-0, a clean sweep throughout. And Dartmouth could bump up the rankings as they beat, if they beat Case on Friday. Final once again, 25-21 of the end of the set. My final thoughts is both back and forth game, and a great way to end on senior night and the final regular season game for our seniors at the Carl Lynch Activity Center as they are getting ready for playoffs coming up soon. We have action for that. On Friday, we will have field hockey against Aponequit senior night. I will be on the call there. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, for our entire crew, Dan Medeiros in the truck, and our entire crew, our cameraman Mikey Burke and Molly Bell, I'm Ben Smith saying so long, everybody.